Welcome to part 3 of my Super Strat build series. This episode is going to have minimal talking. It's long form, there's no background music, and I just want it to be relaxing to watch. I've included chapters in the description if you want to skip around, or you can watch the whole thing through. When I was filming this, I accidentally got my head or my arms directly in front of my camera, particularly during the drilling or screwdriving shots, so some of that footage was unusable. You'll hear me talking in some of the parts of the video because either I screwed something up, I figured something out, or something came out nicely and I wanted to mention it. That's pretty much all I have to say for now, so enjoy the video.
One side is taller than the other. That's weird, I didn't know that. You learn something new every day. But my screws are the same height. Is that right? I don't know if that's right. Yeah, one of these looks like the left is way higher than the right, or the left is way deeper than the right. Yeah, like, I don't know if that's right, but I don't know. Switch batteries. Yeah, these are definitely not straight, but we'll see what we can do. That's it. Okay. Come on. Well, that's no good. Hopefully that will be covered up. Well, that was not too successful. God. So if I don't do that again. That was much better.
Oh my god, I'm such an idiot.
Oh well. pretty cool. That's just what I needed to see today. Oh man. These are staggered. I did not know that. Look at this. Did not say that when I bought it. These are staggered height. Wow. Okay. I'll fix that next time I put this together. This will be fine for now. I can't believe I didn't notice that. Yeah, these definitely need to go deeper in. Probably like nearly all the way in. But for now, it's cool. Figure out a way to get these back further. But other than that, it's gonna be a cool freaking guitar. Do I need more springs? That's crazy. I've never needed more than two. One second. If I push any harder, it's going to strip out the screws. Take it a little bit at a time. I might need to order a new one of these. God. take the tension off. See if that makes a difference. No, the wood is just so... That's crazy. Yeah, it's gonna have to. Okay, so the alignment's not too bad. If you look at the middle strings, it's not. If you look at the D and the G string, the alignment's not too bad. I have just enough space to play the high E string, so. It's not going off the, it's not really going off the neck. That's just fine. I was worried about this for months. This whole alignment thing. That's where it really needs to be. This thing is like floating right now. It needs to be not. And the only way to do that is to get more springs or to drive this farther into the body, which is seems to be impossible right now for some reason. The screw won't go any further. But that's okay. It's good enough progress for today. That's weird. Yeah, definitely needs some tweaking, but good for today. I need to make some dinner. My living room is a mess right now. And there is the guitar. For now, I have to figure out what I'm going to do. Also, remember that I'm going to be using 9-gauge strings on this thing, so that's not going to be a huge problem with the spring thing in the back, but I would like the option to be able to use 10s, so that's kind of annoying, but that's another problem that we will have to solve. And you can see, I've got enough clearance on the high E string. If you use that center dot marker as like a space, like a guide to where the center is, you can see that the G and the D strings are not in the center. But I'm just being extremely picky. But it looks pretty good, I think. And it's a good starting place. I definitely jacked up that top horn, but it's okay. That is part of the learning process. I'm gonna take this thing apart.
When I was off camera, I decided to apply the pickguard so it would be fully assembled as much as I could for the day. What I noticed was that my custom truss rod notch fit extremely well. The bridge and middle pickup routes fit very well too. The only problem was that my humbucker slot in the neck position backfired on me. The Chandler Pickguard and the Butala body are not using the same measurements. I am going to have to revisit the router because not only is the Pickguard too far up, but the humbucker route does not put the screw slot in the correct spot, so there's wood in the way. I probably won't film the routing because I did plenty of routing in part 2. The last thing I have to reflect on is how badly I screwed up the strap buttonhole. After watching the footage back, I realized I had my drill set to the reverse position. That is why it wasn't going through. Hopefully, I will never make that same mistake again, but I probably will one day. Stay tuned for part 4, which will be painting.